Hey y'all, it's Betsy with Happily Ever After, etc. and welcome back to another tablescape. So today I'm working on one of two Bridgerton themed tablescapes because if you are like me, you are super excited for the second half of Bridgerton season 3 to come out. We're not going to talk about it too much because that will be the whole video, but I really wanted to do a Bridgerton themed table, so I ordered some really cute bee themed napkin ring holders. And I asked my mom if she had any china that had gold in it because I don't ever do gold. I love silver, I love rose gold, I love copper. Gold is just not my jam, but it is hers. That is all she does. We're complete polar opposites on that scale. And she has this beautiful blue and gold. Not even 100% sure what it is. I will put the name up on the screen because it has a beautiful hallmark and I can't quite read it, but it is gorgeous. She also has a second one I'll be doing later this afternoon. So she came up with two china patterns. And since this one has a beautiful, beautiful soup tureen and one of my bee themed napkin rings that came in is very big, I thought we would try a centerpiece with fresh flowers that involves the napkin rings. So I'm going to put together a little centerpiece, a low one, in this soup tureen with some flowers that I've picked from my garden and my mom's garden, some white crepe myrtles, some vitex blooms, some hydrangeas, both lace cap and mop head, and some daisies and some white gara. And we will see. I can always go out and get some more. I have some white petunias and other things in the garden, but I'm going to be trying to put the napkin rings kind of tucked in amongst the hydrangea blooms. And I think that'll be really pretty because the china is so delicate and has beautiful teacups. And there's not a great place for a napkin ring with this set in a stack or beside the stack. So we're gonna get started. And I'm going to start with the crepe myrtles because I'm going to try to arrange them kind of as a cross here to support the rest of our flowers. So first, brought some water to the table. We are going to be putting a tablecloth on the table, but I decided I don't want to do the whole tablescape on the tablecloth that I will then have to clean. So we're going to do this and then hopefully be able to move it onto the tablecloth. Let's start. Normally you'll want to strip all your leaves off your flowers, but because I'm trying to create a base, I'm not going to completely remove all the flowers from these crepe myrtle blooms. These two are quite intertwined. And I kind of want this to come out of the bowl very wispy and organic. Now, of course, you can go to your florist or your supermarket and buy blooms. But if you have blooms, always my favorite is to be able to go out in the garden and pick your own blooms. So I'm just trying to kind of create a crossed base at the bottom here. Again, that we can tuck the rest of the petals and flowers through the same way you would use a traditional flower frock. At the very least, remove the bottom flowers, leaves, where they're exactly resting in the petals. There we go. We've got five, which was not intentional. That was just the lowest branches we could reach, but is ideal to work in odd numbers. So good job, Mom. Mom actually picked these for me when she brought the china over. My cut flower garden that I'm growing this year isn't quite ready since I'm growing most of it first from seed. She has a more well-established garden that has a lot more blooms right now. All right. now I think I'm going to go ahead and put some of the Vitex in, because I also want those to kind of drape over the sides. I'm going to clean some of these leaves off because it's just going to start to be a lot of leaves if we don't. Oh, they smell so good. I don't know, but I think we may eventually start to put some of our napkin rings around these guys. You always want to make fresh cuts when you're putting your flowers in water, but as I said, Mom did cut these for me this morning when she brought them, so she is a expert flower arranger, so I am sure she has already cut them nicely. She's pretty good at that. You can see she's stripped most of the leaves off of hers already. Okay, we're getting there. It's pretty so far. Getting all the flowers in the water is definitely interesting, but I'm going to bring y'all in close real quick and show you what I'm talking about when I say I'm crisscrossing the stems to create a network of support for some of the smaller, floppier blooms. So right here in the middle, we are crisscrossing in all the different directions. And of course, we want the entire arrangement to be pretty 360 degrees so that you can see the beautiful porcelain below and the flowers from above. And then we'll tuck our napkin rings right in into the top. Maybe two or three of them. They come in a set of six, so we'll see. All right, back to the stand. All right, let's go ahead and put some of our bigger blooms in. And we can tuck some of the Gara and daisies around them. This is one of her lace head hydrangeas. Lace head sounds wrong. Maybe it's just lace. I don't remember. Something lace. Oh, that's pretty. And we may not use all of the flowers. That's okay too. The Gara. These are such little like fairy blooms. Hoping maybe we can tuck some of these kind of so they're coming up through the blooms above a little bit. That's how they are in the garden. Oh yeah, that's good. All right, so then I have a lot of beautiful, if you've watched any of my garden tours, pink hydrangeas, those are my favorite. Mom has beautiful blue hydrangeas, but quite a few of them are either already spent or just budding up. So she only had a couple that were actually ready to go. That's okay. I'll go ahead and take both of those leaves off because they are big. I'm gonna tuck them on the other side. Perfect. Of course, you know, flower arranging is not a science. It is an art. One I am not trained in. I just kind of go for balance and color. And I do what makes me happy in all things in life. I think that's kind of the goal. But I am growing an entire cut flower garden, like I said earlier. So hopefully this will be the first of many bouquets we do this summer. Ooh, flower down. quite know that we need this one, but we've got it. Let's put it in. It'll definitely be the last one. And then we'll start working some of those Gara up top. We might need to put the in first. So let's see where we could tuck some of these. Oh, this one's going to go right here. Oh, that's pretty. That's very, very pretty. Let me go ahead and tuck one of these leaves we took out right here. Fill up that kind of empty space in the middle. That obviously, now that it's not connected to the plant, will not last days, but that's okay. We can take it out. Hydrangeas, as beautiful as they are not long-lived flowers in a vase. Other things definitely last a lot longer. So, while this is beautiful, we'll have to see how many days it does last for us. I'm gonna put this right in the middle, but it's kind of falling down. It needs something more to support it. I can move this one over and tuck all the napkin rings kind of in the side, because on the side they can rest on the edge of the bowl of the tureen, which is obviously much stronger than the middle here. That'll work better. Oh yeah. That's better. All right, so I'm going to cut one of these daisies, the shortest one down, to tuck in here. Oh, that's nice. That's nice. Let's do a couple more of those. And I like that, even though the bee napkin rings say they are sunflowers, to me they kind of look like daisies. And I think it's just the scale. You expect sunflowers to be much bigger. But if I styled them as sunflowers, and they would, with more yellows and sunny colors, burlap, I'm sure they would read more sunflower-esque. That makes sense. You read the Bridgerton books, there's a passage when Penelope is talking to, I almost said Luke, to Colin, and saying how, as a writer, you know when you've written something really good and you look at it and you're just proud of it and you enjoy it and you like it. I get that same kind of feeling when I'm doing things like this. You know, even if it's not the most textbook right kind of thing, you know when you like it. You know when you think it looks good. And it makes you happy. So far, this is making me very happy. Ooh, I think we're going to be done with the daisies soon, though. Okay. All right, let's do the Gara. We only have a few more of those. I'm just gonna cut them. They all need to be rather adorable pieces, I think. Big petal down here stopping me from getting to the water. Kind of getting lost. Maybe I should have put it down first so I could have done the longer pieces, but that's okay. It'll just be little touches, little blooms, and I think I want to make sure they are all laying down a little more towards the edge as opposed to trying to have them come up through the center. I think that'll be better. All right, last one, and then I will clean up the table, put up the tablecloth, and we will start doing the dishes. That's pretty. That's really pretty. Okay, ready? All right, so we got the tablecloth on, and I decided to go ahead and move all the china onto the table off camera because I actually a bit of a hip injury, and since this is my mom's good china, I wanted to go really, really slow and not accidentally break anything. And I didn't think y'all wanted to watch really, really slow Betsy move china. So it is a beautiful pattern. It really is. Here's a preview up close of one of the butter pats, and there are several serving platters as well that would be beautiful for a large meal. I don't think we'll be using those today because we're not serving a large meal, but I did get out the gravy boat because it's just too pretty. I mean, even if it's just decoration, it should probably be on the table. I was hoping she had a sugar and creamer because that would have just been perfect for a little tea party. Technically, we don't even need all these plates. I asked her to bring me the plates, the teacups, and if she had it, maybe a like salad plate or something. And she said, no, you need the whole set. So all of these will not end up on the table at all for actually eating, but you know, it is kind of nice to set a fancy table, and what other excuse do we have but Bridgerton? We are not fancy people, y'all. So, I wish I had gold silverware. I'm gonna have to get mom some at some point, at the very least, so that I can borrow it for things like this. But in the meantime, I did borrow mom's actual silverware, and this is flatware. I will put links to everything that I know the names of down below, including the silverware and the china. But the china is, you know, it is truly old. It is not really easily found. I don't know that you'll be able to just purchase a set. Mom did say when she dropped it off, be very, very, very careful with the china. It is not replaceable. She brought me, like I said, two sets, this blue. The other set is more of a sage minty green. So that's why I'm doing one blue for Cullen and one sagey green for Penelope. She said, you have to break one, break that one, because it's easily replaceable. I'm like, well, Mom, I'm not going to try to break either. I have broken one bowl already. Not of this set though. So, yay me. Did not mean to. She was here when it happened. I fell taking it out of the car. Hence the hip injury. Did not get the hip injury then. I fell because I have a hip injury. Should not have been touching the china. All right, let me get the glasses. Now, in Bridgerton times, they would have used crystal and actual silver. But unless I'm going to borrow my great grandmother's crystal and sterling silver, this is going to have to do, because my mom has those pieces where they are coming to her. Don't remember she has one. She's waiting for the other. Hopefully we'll wait a very, very, very long time. But I don't want to borrow the crystal, because if I could accidentally hurt one of these things, definitely don't want to hurt family pieces. Add the butter pats. There are also bowls, but I think that would be a little overwhelming for my table. So we're just gonna do the butter pats. This is so pretty. And I like that the table centerpiece is low and easily done. I'm going to go ahead and just tuck the gravy boat here on my sidebar. Rose. I love how this turned out, you guys. I loved using the napkin rings in the flowers. I think that was a really nice way to use them without actually having them as napkin rings on the table. We will be using the other ones on the table, but I think also in the teacups, maybe. I don't remember. No, they are in the teacups with napkins. Oh, I got beautiful velvet napkins for that tablescape. I'm excited. We're going to enjoy this one for a while, and then we will set the other one. I will link them both in the description below. Don't worry, I am going to bring y'all in for a closer look, but leave me a comment down below if you love the centerpiece, if you love the china, or if you are as stinking excited as I am for Bridgerton season 3, part 2. There's no way you're as excited as I am.